They've had great crowds. I expect it to be a full house, a packed house, loud and vocal, and so we got to be ready. And we've really played well in front of big crowds, so I think we're looking forward to going down.
Why do you think that's been the case this year? It seems the road games you've struggled on is when the atmosphere is kind of dead. You win at South Carolina. You played well at the big stage here.
Great question. I don't have an answer for that. I just know we've this year, if it's been a big crowd, we've played well, played hard. So I hope this game is not an exception to what we've done this year.
When you look at their numbers, they've been really good defensively.
Yeah.
In their rebounding. I mean, those are kind of areas that you guys normally are really good in.
Yeah.
Do you think you guys can still get better in those areas?
Dan, I think we can get more consistent on the defensive end. I think we've gotten better on keeping people in front of us. I think we can get a lot better. We can continue to get better. Definitely can get better rebounding, both ends of the floor. We've given up way too many offensive rebounds, which led to way too many points. So in order for us to win the basketball game tomorrow, we're gonna have to keep them off the boards because they thrive on extra chance points, and we're gonna have to try to keep them out of the paint on the defensive end. So we got our work cut out for us, and I think our players are up to the challenge. We're continuing to get better, so we'll get a game plan and try to stick to it. But not giving up transition baskets, keep them out of the paint on penetration, and getting the ball inside and second chance points. That's kind of been our demise.
I know they're coming off a loss, but have you seen them do anything recently that they did better than the first time that you guys played them?
Well, I think they're more consistent. I think they're getting the ball inside. I think that started with our game. So they still play hard. They still play just aggressive, tough defense. And they're going to do what they do. They're not going to change up a lot. They're just not, because they're very good at what they do. So I don't expect them to come out and run us in a zone when they're a great man-to-man basketball team. So, I just think they got a little bump in the road, and they're going to refocus and get ready for their senior night and last home game.
They've been real good defensively against you recently. What do they do? What's their MO that allows them to be so strong in that respect?
Well, I think their defense, I think they're aggressive on the ball. They get after the ball handler. They deny certain people. They allow you. They don't want you to get in your comfort zone, so they stretch the defense out. They try to make you play fast. And so as we have to make sure that we control the basketball, don't let us get flustered, and keep our turnovers low, and that'll help us.
Don said they were big blue, of course, Thursday, pulling for Kentucky, and now they're all big orange.
We were big blue, too.
She's pulling for you guys, because obviously either they share the title or win it
outright.
So, but this, I realize you're going to know going in what your seeding is, but Diamond was saying this is an important game for SEC seeding,
yeah.
NCAA seeding. Just how do you get your team to realize, you got to do what you can do Sunday to help yourself?
I think our young ladies understand the what's at stake and what we're playing for, and more than anything, it's just a pride thing of going down and finishing out the regular season on a win. So we know that it'll help in seedings. And you know, we're not going in there trying to help somebody else win an SEC championship, but we're going in there just to continue to get better and compete, and try to win. That's our goal. I mean, we feel good about it. We've had some great practices, and we're still stinging from when they beat us here. So I think that in itself will motivate us as well.
How are y'all just in terms of health?
Yeah, we're good. Everybody's healthy, and everybody will practice, so ready to go, really.
And Diamond didn't have any repercussions from
playing? No, not that I know of. Not that I know of. She was fine. Thank goodness.
The last time you guys played Mississippi State, they're one of the many teams that you guys played close but couldn't get them down the stretch. How much does that Florida win earlier this week, gutting out a close game, maybe help with confidence in this?
Well, you know, great question, because we've been in games that we have been ahead the last 3 minutes and it's slipped away, and then we've been in games where we have been behind and then we've pulled it out. So we've been through so many different scenarios. So, yeah, I think the Florida game helps us, and I think the understanding of how we played them the last time, and hopefully that'll carry over and we can finish the deal out. But we've seemed to have been through all scenarios of games, and I can't help to think that it'll prepare us down the road.
How much or what have you guys changed or improved since last time you played them?
Gosh, I think we've gotten better defensively. Can we get better? Absolutely. But we continue to work on our defense. We're rebounding the basketball a little bit better. We got room for improvement. I think we're pushing the basketball more. We've cut down on our turnovers for the most part. It's been so up and down, but I think in the games that we've been solid, we've cut down on our turnovers. So just want to stay healthy and be able to go down there and compete. Like I said, we've had some great practices. We've had good preparation. We've watched tape and just getting ready to finish it out.
You seem to have found your effective fifth starter too in Alexa. Do you intend to leave the starting lineup the way it's going now?
She and Mimi are so interchangeable, and Alexa's really, I think, producing right now, and Mimi's done some good things off the bench, so. I'm not going to change anything that's, I don't think is broken, really. I think Lex has been very valuable to us, and we kept her in the game towards the end of the game against Florida, and I thought her defense just stepped up tremendously. So as I think people may think she may be a liability on defense, she certainly wasn't in the Florida game down the stretch.
And this, just to jump ahead to next week, this SEC tournament is going to be one of the most competitive in
I think so.
You guys have just beat up on each other all season.
Yeah.
Are you guys looking forward to sort of the restart there when you get to the tourney?
I think so. But you got the SEC tournament is such a grind. It's just a grind, and it's physical, and you don't have to do this any part of your year except an SEC tournament to play back to back to back to back. So it is a grind. It's tough. It's tough on your body. It'll be tough on us because of our numbers, but I don't know. You look at everybody's roster in the SEC, and everybody seems to have low number rosters. So I think it's going to be interesting. I think it's going to be a little bit of a chess match on what you can get away with and what you can't and what you got to save and what you don't. So it's always interesting. There's always, you know, if you're a fan of women's basketball, I think it's one of the best tournaments you can go to, because every game seems to be really, really go down the wire, and it's been exciting in the past. So,
I know you're probably not going to spell out your game plan, but with Vivian's, what makes her so special? It feels like they run a lot of their offense through what she does so well. And what can you guys do to hopefully limit her?
Well, I think she's an exceptional talent that can shoot the three, is quick to go to the basket, is a quick jumper, great mid-range jumper. So you just got to try to limit her touches, and when she gets it, you just got to try to keep her in front of you and contest every shot. I mean, she's outstanding, and there's not too many. She's a volume shooter, so there's not too many players like Vivian's that has that talent. And man, she can shoot you right in right into a game, and she's deadly. So we just got to try however we can to try to limit her touches and try to be a little physical with her and make her shoot overs. And that's I'm sitting here saying that, but that's easier said than done.